Countdown.
Tahniah. Siaran langsung ini dibawakan khas kepada anda oleh Akademi YouTuber Malaysia. Sebuah inisiatif E-Didik Malaysia dan Kelab Guru Malaysia. Tumpukan perhatian anda. Siaran langsung akan bermula sebentar lagi. Link sijil akan diberikan di hujung siaran ini. Pastikan diisi dalam tempoh yang ditetapkan. Terima kasih.
Hai, Assalamualaikum. Selamat malam pada semua guru-guru, ibu bapa dan pelajar yang saya kasihi sekalian. Okey, selamat datang ke Tuition Academy 3 sekali lagi dengan usaha sama E-Didik Malaysia dan Kelab Guru Malaysia bermula percuma selamanya percuma. Bagi mendapatkan keberkatan, okay, mari kita membaca umur kita Al-Fatihah bagi yang Muslim dan bagi yang non-Muslim membaca dengan doa masing-masing. Baik. Apa khabar semua pada malam ini? Kita sama-sama ya berjumpa lagi kita di mana kita melalui channel Cikgu Nur Naini HR di mana saya nak perkenalkan diri saya dulu. Sekali lagi saya Cikgu Wahidah binti Zakaria ataupun Cikgu Wawa selaku moderator pada malam ini. Dan pada malam ini kita di kelas tuition biologi pra-university. Okey, di mana ini adalah kelas kali ke-9 melalui channel Cikgu Nur Naini HR. Okey, pada malam ini kita bersiaran langsung di channel Cikgu Nur Naini HR. So siapa yang belum subscribe channel beliau, sila subscribe dan tekan butang loceng untuk notifikasi kelas seterusnya. Baik, nama penuh beliau adalah Nur Naini binti Harun dari Pusat Tingkatan 6 Sekolah Menengah Kebangsaan Sultan Sulaiman Kuala Terengganu. Dan tajuk kita pada malam ini okay, adalah Sliding Filament Theory of Muscle Contraction. Maksudnya okay, kita dah lihat pergerakan otot ini. So melalui satu hipotesis lah ya, iaitu Sliding Filament Theory. Dan kita akan bersiaran langsung selama satu jam. Okay, bersama kita juga pada malam ini adalah Ketua Panitia Subjek Biologi iaitu Puan Nur Faizah Ahmad daripada Kolej Matrikulasi Negeri 9 dan juga sebagai co-host. Okay.
Assalamualaikum semua. Okay.
Salam. Dan juga Puan Fatiah ya daripada Pusat Tingkatan 6 Sekolah Menengah Kebangsaan Seri Serdang Selangor sebagai pemerhati. Hai Cikgu Fatiah.
Okay, Assalamualaikum. Hai, Assalamualaikum.
Okay, so baik. Sebelum kita teruskan kelas kita ya, ingin saya ingatkan semua pelajar dan penonton yang ingin hantarkan komen ya agar menggunakan bahasa yang sopan dan gambar profil yang bersesuaian ya untuk tuntunan umum. Dan jom kita tunjukkan disiplin yang baik ya. Dan anda boleh involve ya tanya soalan dekat chat box di sebelah situ. Okey, dan sila fokus ya pada pelajaran yang akan disampaikan oleh Cikgu Nur Naini. Jadi insya-Allah semoga kelas kita pada malam ini bermanfaat sepenuhnya bagi para pelajar semua. Tanpa membuang masa lagi, jom kita serahkan kelas kepada Cikgu Nur Naini. Dipersilakan.
Okey, terima kasih Cikgu Wawa selaku moderator. Okey, Assalamualaikum dan selamat malam semua. Okey, terima kasih kepada Cikgu Faizah dan juga Cikgu Fatiah rakan bersama Biologi Perayu. Okey, jadi sebelum kita mulakan kelas pada malam ini, seperti biasa Cikgu akan perkenalkan diri Cikgu dulu, iaitu yang telah disebutkan tadi. Okey, Cikgu adalah Cikgu Nur Naini binti Harun atau lebih dikenali sebagai Cikgu Naini HR. Okey, Cikgu berasal daripada Terengganu, okey, mengajar di Pusat Tingkatan 6 SMK Sultan Sulaiman Kuala Terengganu. Dan teaching experience 23 tahun, okay. Teaching in biology STPM dan juga SPM. Dan 17 tahun dalam mengajar biologi STPM. So my channel okay, adalah Cikgu Nur Naini HR. Okay. Okay, di Cikgu Nur Naini HR channel, okay, sebanyak video content di dalam channel Cikgu Nunaini Isyarat channel. Okay. Dan juga you all boleh lihat pada subjek lain dalam Prayu Collaborative Playlist. Okay, so my head panel, dikongsi tadi iaitu Cikgu Nur Faizah Ahmad. She's from College Matrikulasi Negeri Sembilan Kuala Pilah. And teaching experience 26 years. Okay, 15 years at boarding school and 11 years at College Matrikulasi Negeri Sembilan. So her channel is Cikgu Faizah. And my other teammate, Cikgu Fatiah binti Mangsa. She's from PTE, Pusat Tingkatan 6 SMK Seri Serdang Selangor. And teaching experience 29 years. Almost 30 years this year. 20 years in Form 6. And her channel is Cikgu Fatiah 66. And my last teammate is yang lebih muda, Cikgu Wahidah binti Zakaria. She's from College Matrikulasi Pahang and teaching experience 11 years and teaching biology and matriculation Pahang, And her channel is Oh My Biology by Miss Wawa. Okay, class, we also have other subject, mathematics, which their tuition is on Saturday every 5 p.m. So which is led by teacher In and other teachers, teacher Aileen, teacher Zarina and other teachers in this mathematic. So you can see in their mathematic video collection in collaborative Prayu playlist. Others chemistry, so which tuition on Sunday, 3:30 p.m. Which is led by Cikgu Shahnan and other teacher, Cikgu Vivi, Cikgu Tan, Cikgu Mawar, And also perakaunan and ekonomi Prayu for matriculation and also SPM, which held on Wednesday, 9:30 p.m. Which is led by Madam Fizi, Cikgu Yati, Cikgu Li and Cikgu Yi. So other STPM subject you can see for pengajian UM, MUET, pengajian perniagaan, perakaunan STPM and all of this you can see their tuition, tuition jadual tuition tu dalam portal www.academyyoutuber.com. So jangan lupa sentiasa mengunjungi portal akademi untuk mendapatkan kelas tuition percuma sepanjang cuti. Okay, so what we want to learn today, is tonight. So what is the topic today? This is continue from last tuition, which is about the muscle. And now we discuss about the sliding filament theory of muscle contraction. Teacher, now this topic is a little difficult to memorize the process. So I hope in this tuition you can analyze and understand what is the mechanism. Sometimes in matriculation they say sliding filament theory. STPM we say sliding filament hypothesis. And sometimes we other say sliding filament model. So this is the same thing. Sliding filament theory or hypothesis or model of a muscle contraction. So relate to the syllabus for STPM semester 2. You must explain the mechanism. So the mechanism is the process. According to the sliding filament hypothesis or model or theory. And also in matriculation semester 2, they are also need to explain the mechanism of muscle contraction based on sliding filament theory. So the same thing we want to discuss this tonight.
Terlupa nak sebutkan kod yang pertama kita pada malam ini. Boleh Kak saya sebut sebelum akak start?
Boleh je.
Sebelum Puan Nani start, kod kita pada malam ini yang pertama adalah nombor 7. Okey, nombor 7. Okey, terima kasih Kak.
Okey, so kelas jangan lupa ya, kod tu ada 4. Ah, ni baru 1. Okey, so teacher continue. Okay, so sliding filament hypothesis is introduced, okay, introduced by two British biologists, okay, which name is Hush Halley and Andrew Huxley. Okay, this is not the sibling, eh, they are another other person, okay, same, maybe same name, okay, their family name is same. Okay, so this theory explains the muscle contraction. Okay, because their conclusion in their founding is the muscle shortens, okay, the muscle shorten as the acting, okay, you already know the acting, where is the acting, where is the myosin, okay, the muscle shorten as the actin and myosin filaments slide past one other, okay, so you see this, okay, this is actin, this is myosin, okay, so you're going to slide, okay, past each other, okay, macam dipanggil zigzag, lebih kurang z, dia slide, okay, sliding, okay, eh? Okay, so before we understand the mechanism, okay, teacher refresh again what you have learned before this about the structure, eh? Structure of muscle and the structure that involved in muscle contraction is, okay, the myosin, okay, which is the thick filament, okay, see here the thick filament and actin, okay, so actin is the thin filament and the calcium ion, which is in sarcoplasmic reticulum, okay, remember sarcoplasmic reticulum, where is sarcolemma? Okay, that's one important, eh, to the what we say when we discuss about the mechanism, you need to tell, eh, where calcium ion come from. Okay, so calcium ion in sarcoplasmic reticulum and also ATP, okay, ATP in muscle, okay. Okay, so let we discuss detail about the myosin, the actin, calcium ion, ATP, about the structure and also their role, eh, in muscle contraction before teacher going to discuss about the mechanism. Okay, okay, let's start the first about myosin. Okay, so myosin filament, myosin is a thick filament. Okay, so the thick filament, the myosin molecules are bound together to form thick filament. Okay, so we see that, okay, this is thick filament. So myosin molecule, okay, they have myosin head. Okay, can move up and down. Okay, up and down. Okay, sorry, eh. Okay, so it can move up and down, okay, like this and then sometimes down, okay. To make the cross bridge with actin, the thin filament, okay. And so this give power stroke for muscle contraction, okay. Power stroke, that means attach and then you move to the center of the sarcoma. Okay, power stroke macam satu daya tarikan ke dalam, eh, ke dalam sarcoma. Okay, center of the sarcoma. Okay, so teacher hope you already know about the sarcoma. Okay. Okay, the role of ATP. Okay, so the role of ATP. Okay, so ATP is a high energy molecule. Okay, which will bind with myosin binding site and hydrolyze into ADP and inorganic phosphate. Okay, so ATP attached to the myosin head. Okay, so this head look like this. Okay, because ATP is energy molecule, so it will energize, okay, when hydrolyze and then release ADP and inorganic phosphate, so will change the head to become cord, eh, cord ni macam tegak lah, okay, and then power stroke bend, okay, tarik ke depan, okay, tu dia punya role, okay, so the role is bind with myosin binding site, hydrolyze into ADP and inorganic phosphate and give a power stroke for muscle contraction. Okay, so we know that the chemical energy ATP has been transformed into mechanical energy. Okay, so ATP hydrolyzed and give mechanical energy for contraction. And you must also know the role of ATP is also for disconnecting the myosin cross bridge from binding from the binding site after power stroke. That means if this one to detach from the what we say the actin, the ATP must bind and then it going to the normal position. Okay, so this is the role of ATP. Okay, so sometimes in enzyme, they want you to give what we say the role of ATP. Okay, about 2 marks or 3 marks. Okay, you can say about this. Okay, here they detach from the binding site. Okay, how about the thin filament? Okay, so thin filament role the major for muscle contraction. Okay, so the thin filament, they have 3 subunits. Okay, composed of actin. Okay, so this is actin subunit. Look like a pearl. Okay, this is actin subunit. And you see that tropomyosin cover the what we say the hole. Okay, so what is the hole here? Okay, so the hole here is referred to the binding site. Okay, for myosin cross bridge. Okay, so you see again the structure. Okay, so the troponin. Troponin here. Look like the what we say yang apa bentuk bulat bulat yang bersambung. Okay, macam what we say key. Okay, so the troponin. Okay, the role of troponin. Troponin attach the myosin strand will expose the binding site when there are cation ion. Okay, so when there are cation ion, it going like this. Okay, so if I show you again. Okay, here. Okay, let me see here. Okay, when the cation ion reach, okay, at the actin, so it will make the troponin. Okay, see. Okay, so the cover, the binding site will expose. Okay, so when they have the cation ion only. Okay, so these three molecule, the actin, the troponin, and protropomycin, mean a major for the muscle contraction. Okay, and the last one is cation ion. So cation ion will release when action potential arrive. Okay, so the action potential arrive at what we say here is T to bull. Okay, so T to bull. When action potential arrive at T to bull, so the cation ion are released from sarcoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so what happened? It will bind to the cation binding site at troponin. Okay, so bind here. Okay, so bind here, and then this cause a conformation chain and move aside the tropomyosin strand and expose the binding site. Okay, so we see here, so this already exposed. Okay, so if I show you again. Okay, before. Okay, before here. Okay, before here, the cation ion and then going to the troponin. So it will expose the binding site. Okay, binding site for myosin. So this myosin will attach here, the binding site. Okay, so you already know about the main important what we say structure and also what we say ion and ATP in the muscle contraction. Okay, so we going to the mechanism. Okay, yeah.
Saya nak bagi kod untuk yang kedua.
Okay, sila.
Kod yang kedua kita pada malam ini adalah nombor 2. Okay, nombor 2. Okay, boleh sambung.
Okay, so we continue. Okay, so let's discuss about the mechanism of muscle contraction. Okay, so this is about the muscle contraction. Okay, so what important thing is they have five steps. Okay, for the first one, the exposure of binding site on actin. And then the second one, the binding of myosin to form cross bridge. Okay, the third one is the power stroke. Okay, that means the power stroke. Okay. And then disconnecting the cross bridge from actin. And the last one, re-energizing and reoriented of myosin. That means the myosin return to the normal. Okay, so this is a one cycle of the cross bridge. Okay, so remember, if you see there are more myosin here, more in the myosin filament. Okay, so this only we discuss only one cross bridge. Okay, so when you explain, just explain this one only. Yeah, so make but you must understand the cross bridge is more than one. Okay, because the movement tu, pergerakan dia tu mesti orang kata sampai ke menghampiri center selagi ada fascian. Okay, dan benda ini, this first sliding filament is continue until until the fascian is returned back to the sarcoplasmic. Okay, so let me discuss about this one cross bridge. Okay, starting from the first one. Okay, step one. Okay, when action potential spread to the T tubule, okay, here is the T tubule. Okay, so when potential arrive here and then spread to the T tubule, okay, so calcium here. Okay, this stimulate calcium ion to release from sarcoplasmic reticulum. So calcium ion release from sarcoplasmic reticulum and then bind to the troponin. Okay, bind to the troponin, and then what happened? The causing change in shape of what? Okay, shape of the shape of the actin. Okay, so the troponin, so this troponin will push the what we say here, this strand, this will for what? Tropomyosin. Okay, so troponin push tropomyosin away and expose binding site of actin filament. Okay, so see the binding site of actin filament expose. Okay, so expose, so we going to myosin head, okay, to bind with them. Okay, so the step two, ATP bound to the before the muscle contraction. Okay, you must know the ATP is bound to myosin head during muscle in rest. Okay, and beside the ATP, okay, this ATP, there are also the enzyme, the enzyme that promote this process. Okay, so the enzyme is ATPase, so ATPase, okay, here. Okay, why ATPase is needed? Okay, for ATP hydrolysis ATP. Okay, that means ATPase is used for ATP to hydrolyze. Okay, to form or split to form ADP and PI. PI that refer to inorganic phosphate. And then remember, ADP and PI still attached to the myosin head. Okay, So this state we say the myosin head is energized state. Okay, so when ATP hydrolyzed, the myosin head got energy. Okay, so it will pot. Okay, pot that means straight. Eh? Tegakkan kepala and then bind to the exposed binding site on actin and form cross bridge. Okay, so when we get energy, okay, we also pot kan. Okay, bertenaga straight. Okay, so like that. Myosin head in energized state pot and bind to exposed binding site on actin and form cross bridge. Okay, so remember PI and ADP stay at the head. And the first one, the inorganic phosphate is released. Okay, so release here. Okay. And that triggers a conformation chain in the myosin head. Okay, so the myosin head bend. Okay, this one the bend. And then give the, okay, the power stroke. Okay, that mean bend and then give the power stroke. Okay, so here is the power stroke. That mean move to the center of the sarcomere. Okay, so here is the power stroke. And during this power stroke, ADP is released. Okay, so the first one, inorganic phosphate release, and then I give the myosin head conformation chain. Okay, that means the myosin head bend and this give a power stroke that pull actin closer to the center of sarcomere, and then during this power stroke the ADP is released. Okay, so complete. The two this inorganic and ADP is released. Okay, and in order to disconnect the cross bridge from actin, and ATP must bind to its side of myosin heads. Okay, so it is the disconnect. So the ATP must bind to the myosin head. Okay, so no cross bridge is formed. Eh? Okay, so disconnect. And okay, so it is going to the normal position of myosin. And this process will repeat when there are sufficient calcium ion present. Eh? Okay, so it point. Okay, what we say before. Okay, this is not the one proper, one cross bridge. There must be another cross bridge. Okay, but it's not the what we say. Bertembung. Okay, they must kata sequence. Okay, the first and the second and so on. Okay, okay, so this is the fourth step. And the last one, okay, when calcium ion is actively transport from cytosol into the sarcoplasmic reticulum by ion bond, that means the calcium ion will transport to the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Eh? So there are no contraction of the muscle. Okay. So if calcium ion sufficient, it's going to contract. Okay. So as the calcium ion is removed, the tropomyosin covers the binding site on actin. Okay, so you see the tropomyosin going back to the normal position, so it will cover the binding site of actin. Okay, so teacher Wawa.
Okay, so
kita nak rest.
We have an hour, so kita nak break sekejap ya. Stay tuned, kembali selepas ini.
Okay.
Alah, apa ni? PKPB lagi. SPM pula ditangguhkan. Jenuhlah nak bayar yuran tuition. Pernah dengar tentang tuition percuma? Kami di Akademi YouTuber menyediakan tuition online secara percuma kepada anda semua. Ada prasekolah, sekolah rendah, sekolah menengah, STPM juga untuk matrikulasi. Percuma je. Jom layari laman sesawang www.academyyoutuber.com.
Baik, kembali bersama Cikgu Fatihah. Cikgu Fatihah pula, Cikgu Nonaini, minta maaf. Okey, Cikgu Nonaini.
Okey. Okey, Cikgu Bawa nak baca kod ya?
Saya akan baca pada minit ke 40 nanti.
Okay, so okay, so kita teacher continue. Okay, so what teacher has said already, there are multiple cross bridge cycle. Okay, so the process before I say about the one cross bridge. Okay, so there are actually there are the series of the cross bridge that pull the actin filament toward the center of sarcoma. As what we say, the they have the sufficient calcium ion. Okay, sebab itu kalau ikutnya, ion calcium ni penting kan untuk otak kan. Okay, so kalau katakan banyak calcium ion, maka berlakulah kekerapan apa otot-otot itu untuk contract tu. Okay, okay. So the all cross bridge are neither bound nor disconnect at the same time. Okay, they not okay. What we say apa? Macam bertembung, okay. So, dia bound and disconnect not at the same time. Okay, that means a sequence lah. Okay, tersusun. Okay, eh. Okay, so, teacher hope you can memorize. Okay, I give you 5 steps. And there are about 13 points. Eh. In exam, if you want to describe, okay. For example, when in essay question, okay, explain the mechanism of a muscle contraction using sliding filament hypothesis. Okay, about if I'm not mistaken, about 7 or 8 marks. Okay, so there are about 11, 12. Okay, so I hope you can manage to answer if this sliding filament hypothesis come in essay question. Okay. Okay, so teacher, hope you all understand. Okay, if any question that confusing, okay, you can type in the comment. Okay, so teacher will be answer what is the confusing idea. Okay, okay. After this, we're going to practice. Okay, so so I forgot to. What is it show you about this mechanism? Okay, this one. Okay, you see that not what we say not not in the same time. Okay, the bound. Okay, the bound and the disconnect is not at the same time. Okay. Okay, so we going to the practice. Cikgu Wawa, tak ada siapa tanya ke whatever. Tak ada. Okay, kalau tak ada, we going to the practice.
Boleh lagi. Okay, come on students. Boleh tanya soalan dekat chat box. Tajuk ni menarik ni. Kita faham ke tidak?
Okay. If not, okay, we going, teacher going to test you. Okay, so let's go the first one. Simple. Okay, simple question about the function. Okay, the formation of action potential in a muscle fiber. Okay, will cause the calcium ion to be released from the okay sarcolemma, sarcoplasm, myosin filament, sarcoplasmic reticulum. Okay, so teacher hope you all can answer this one. Okay, so teacher waiting for the answer.
Okay, kamu student boleh cuba jawab. Dekat mana calcium ion release from?
Okay. Sarcolemma. Okay, where the sarcolemma? Sarcolemma? sarcoplasm, sarcoplasmic reticulum, the myosin filament.
So we have answer from Lin Suk Teng and Zin Chai D for donkey. Sarcoplasmic reticulum, is it correct?
Okay, yes, the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Okay, ada student yang jawab sarcolemma ke sarcoplasm?
Ada yang jawab C for myosin filament.
Oh, the myosin filament.
Sarcoplasmic
reticulum. Okay, so myosin filament, okay, myosin filament yang apa?
Yang macam structure tu kan?
Okay, kalau kita tengok balik cuka cikgu going through the okay, gambar yang mula-mula tu. Sekejap
banyak mekanism.
That's okay. So the answer is here. Okay, this is refer to the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Okay, we see the like that the membrane lebih kurang. Okay, this one. This is sarcoplasmic reticulum. Okay, sarcoplasmic reticulum here.
It's actually an area kan? It's an area. Kawasan.
Okay, so kawasan. So here they are calcium, they are also ATP. Okay, sarcolemma here. Sarcolemma is refer to the light membrane lah. Okay, that cover the what we say the muscle. Okay, so teacher hope you understand about the myosin. Myosin here. So myosin here. Okay. So we go to the practice seterusnya. Okay. Kita tengok semula.
Okay, next question. Lepas question kedua kita akan bagi kod ketiga
Okay. This about the process. Okay, so this is complicated. Nampak. Tapi this dia punya apa sebahagian not overall the mechanism. Okay, only the starting. Okay, the step. If not mistaken, step one and step two. Okay, step one and step two only. Okay, so let teacher read the question. Okay, the events during skeletal muscle contraction are given below. Okay, this multiple choice question, this is famous in objective. Okay, so you must understand and then choose the very best answer. Okay, so this the process must be in sequence. Okay, we start first and so on. Okay, so troponin change shape exposing the actin binding site. Okay, troponin change shape exposing the actin binding site. Calcium is released and binds to the troponin complex. Okay, transverse tubule. Okay, T-tubule, we call it transverse tubule. Depolarize the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Okay, bending of the myosin heads exert force on the thin filament. Okay, and production of action potential across the postsynaptic membrane. Okay, so which one is the answer? Okay, starting with what? And then ending with what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
So okay, here we have several answer. Okay, Farah Ain said choose C. Suk Teng choose C. Ada juga yang choose B. Okay, so kecuali A. Ada yang jawab B, ada C, ada D kecuali A. So what is the sequence or events?
Okay, teacher give keywords kat sini. Okay, the key. Okay, either C or D, which is the best? Okay, either C or D. Okay, A A memang tak nampak Okay, so we not starting for the calcium. Okay, starting production of action potential. Yes, action potential must reach the T2 first. Okay, So across the postsynaptic membrane, what you say, this one, the junction kan, okay. So this postsynaptic, and then going to the T tubule, and then going to the muscle. Okay, so production of action potential across the postsynaptic membrane, yes. And then depolarize the T tubule here. Okay. And then, okay, and then cation ion is released. Remember, when the action potential arrive at T tubule, cation ion here, and then going to the this. This is the about the actin and the actin and the myosin, okay. And then the troponin chain shape exposing the actin binding site. And the last one is the bending of myosin head exert force on the actin filament. Okay, so the answer is D. D for donkey. Okay, so we student, ada student ni siapa nama yang jawab betul tu?
Ramai ni.
Ramai, okay.
Okay. Apa nama tu, teknik dia tu.
Okay. So good congrats. Okay, we answer the D. Okay. This
Kita nak cakap kod. Boleh?
Okay. So yang kod yang ketiga.
Okay, kod yang ketiga, kita ada nombor 8. Nombor 8. Okay? So you boleh combine kod yang tadi lah.
Okay. Yeah. So ada three number. Okay. So let we go to the third question. Okay. This are the objective question. Okay. So the answer is D. Okay. This is a simple one. Okay. The role of tropomyosin in skeletal muscle is to. Okay. This is the easy one. I hope all correct. Hold cation ion in place, catalyze hydrolysis of ATP, form an actin myosin cross bridge, and a block myosin binding site on actin.
Okay, come on, student. The role of tropomyosin. Tropomyosin tu yang mana? Kalau ikut gambar rajah tadi tu?
Tropomyosin yang mana?
Yang mana? Mungkin dia nak recall yang mana satu tropomyosin.
Okay, nak going to the gambar semula tu. Jangan nak keep going. Okay, harap boleh memorize lah gambar yang kat mana. Okay, tropomyosin yang bentuk per tu adalah acting. Okay. So bayangkan okay, bentuk per ni cikgu lukilah lebih kurang. Okay, per ni sebenarnya ada hole kan. Okay. And then dia bentuk dia macam apa? Helical, dia ada dua strand. Okay. So lebih kurang lah macam ni. Cantik tak cikgu lukis. Okay. And then they have the tropomyosin cover. Cover. Okay, kemudian dia ada key dia. Mesti dia kunci dia. Kunci dimainkan oleh troponin. Okay, adalah kunci kat sini troponin. Bila kunci ni kena calcium baru dia movekan tropomyosin. So apa peranan tropomyosin tu?
Okay, so all of them answer D for donkey. Block myosin binding site on the actin.
Yeah, correct. Okay, so block the myosin binding site on actin. Okay, teacher draw nampak kan? Okay, like that. Okay, so the answer is block myosin binding site. Okay, and remember tropomyosin will dia akan expose binding site tu apabila troponin lekat dengan bind with the cation ion. Okay so finish about the objective. Okay, so let we going to the difficult one. Okay, about the essay. Okay, so we have more time. Okay, so teacher hope in comment, okay, in chat box, okay, just state what other we say the idea. Okay, the idea for the question. Okay, so this one this is a example of essay question. Okay, so this question need you to describe. Okay, describe the role of calcium ion and ATP in muscle contraction. Okay, let me discuss about the role of calcium ion first. Okay, so what's the role? Okay, teacher said that means more than one. What's the role of calcium ion? Okay, so teacher hope you can type the what we say the one of the role. Okay, so teacher Wawa can read what is the role by her. Okay. So what's the role? That mean more than one.
Roles means function or important of calcium ion. That right, Cikgu?
Yeah, yeah. That starting. That mean. Okay. That mean. Any remember? Must be in muscle contraction.
Okay, Farah Ain answer the calcium ion role as to change shape of troponin. Is it correct? Change the shape of troponin.
Change the shape of troponin. Calcium ion. Okay, yes. It's one of the rule. Okay, again. And then?
Or other answer from anybody else? Ada lagi?
Okay, when you describe, okay, that means, okay, a student, when you describe, that means, okay, Farah Ain said the role of calcium ion, yes, they will change, what we say, teacher Hawa? The role, what Farah Ain sebut ni?
Change the shape of troponin.
Yes, okay, that's the role of calcium ion, okay, change the shape of troponin, tapi you must describe, macam mana tu? Chain tu, macam mana dia chain tu? Before that,
dia mesti release from the sarcoplasmic reticulum first.
Yes.
Pada troponin tu.
And then, okay, because describe that mean kena explain. Okay, rule yes, you can get the point for rule, but describe. So the describe that means explain. Okay, so the teacher said that means the point. Okay, okay, rule already have. Okay, before that, okay, change the shape before that. Must be bayangan, okay. And then, calcium ion come from, so like that. Okay, ada.
Bind and change the shape of the troponin. Kalau boleh, bind to where? Kalau boleh, ayat kita di detail kan, bind to which part, kan? Which
side,
kan?
Boleh lah. Okay, bind to the okay, bind to the troponin.
Actually, dekat troponin tu, actually it has the calcium binding site kan?
Kena so sebut.
I think Farah Ain, you can detail the answer.
Okay, okay, that's a good try, okay, to get one from the okay, the rule of calcium ion. Okay, they have a 3 points here. Okay, other student yang answer panjang ke, yang tak answer ke?
Banyak ni, 9 marks.
The rule of calcium, they have from 9, they have 3, okay, but because this one they are also the ATP, so ATP is more than, okay, so the rule of calcium, there are 3 points when you describe the rule of calcium ion, okay, so teacher give you the, okay, the answer, like this, okay. So as teacher Wawa said, bind to the troponin and change the shape, configuration, shape, okay, yes. And then tropomyosin is pushed away. Okay, so that's the role of calcium ion. That means after that, okay, that describe the role of calcium ion. And then yang teacher Wawa said, apa? Myosin binding site exposed, kan? Okay, yes. Myosin binding site on actin are exposed. Okay, this...
ada lagi satu point. Farah Ain, she answer, therefore it cause a synaptic vesicle to fuse with plasma membrane and release neurotransmitter. Adakah this is related to the function of calcium?
This a function, yes, but this this question is about the muscle contraction. So the role of calcium ion in muscle contraction, only in muscle. Okay, that's before that kan. Okay, tu berada dekat apa we said, dekat apa the synapse kan. Situ.
So not accepted this point.
So this 3 point, starting bind and then chain and then after that and then expose. Okay, that is the role of the calcium. Okay, sebab kalau tak ada calcium, benda tu troponin tak akan expose binding tu. Dia tak akan push away the tropomyosin. Okay, so that's describe the role of calcium. Okay, we go to the second part. Okay, this is 3 marks. Okay, so another 9 marks. Okay, so describe about the ATP. And then ATP in muscle contraction. That means ATP. Okay, so in mechanism and sliding filament theory, ATP play a major role to join the actin, to move the myosin head. Okay, so there are about 6 points. When we discuss about the ATP, the role of ATP in muscle contraction. Okay, so student can give one idea. Okay, they have 6 ideas.
So kalau betul soalan ni, the function of ATP as the energy molecule kan, cikgu kan?
Yeah.
Is enzyme kan? Dia bukan tanya enzyme ATP is tadi. Dia tanya ATP molecule. ATP.
Boleh kalau kalau nak masuk mekanisme dia ATP ni nanti dia akan hydrolyze okay with the aid of ATPase. Okay, that's okay. That the major role is ATP. What ATP do?
ATP hydrolyze, it needs ATPase enzyme to hydrolyze. What your idea class?
Okay, so can jot down the idea in chat box. Okay.
Boleh buka buku cikgu?
Boleh je. Tak ada masalah. Tapi gunakan buku yang apa, yang Campbell ke whatever ke, Dung Fajar-Fajar, Sport whatever. Okay. To use the recommend by the syllabus. Okay. So Farah Ain, I know they have the book. Okay. My student. So other student, I know they also buy the Campbell book. Okay. Okay, so they have about going
bagi,
to
boleh
pergi hang. Okay, so ATP bind myosin head. Okay, and then dia chain the the shape of the myosin head. Okay, remember myosin head at rest apa? ATP buat apa?
Okay, kita ada satu jawapan daripada Zing Chai. Okay, bind with myosin binding site. Meaning that ATP bind with myosin binding site and hydrolyze into ADP and inorganic phosphate. Is it correct?
Myosin binding site. Boleh lah. Jadi sebenarnya ATP tu dia bind dekat myosin head tu. Macam myosin binding site ni macam refer kepada actin pula. Nanti kan confusing. Okay, ATP tu bind at the myosin head.
Kalau tengok tadi tu, myosin head tu yang macam kepala apa, tauge tu kan?
Yang ni. Kalau ikutnya ni, ATP bind kat sini ni. Kalau binding site tu yang dekat actin tu, dekat actin tu yang ada hole tu, that's the myosin binding site.
Okay, myosin next will bind to the site.
Okay, so ada lagi idea lain?
No one setakat ni belum lagi. Okay, kalau point ni dapat berapa markah cikgu?
Bind. Ya, ini Kalau ikut bind tu, yes, okay, get. Cuma binding site tu, that's kita confusing sikit. Okay, tapi yang selepas tu tu, okay, bolehlah sikit. Okay, tapi kalau kalau ikutnya, kalau benda tu relate, okay, dia pun maybe mostly tak terima sebab benda tu macam apa, end lah, benda tu terlekat. So, benda tu yang menyebabkan idea tu jadi salah. Okay, missing binding site. Okay.
Dia salah konsep tu kan?
Jadi nampak. Yes. So ada ke idea lain?
Sebenarnya tak ada lagi.
Okay, kalau macam tu teacher.
Okay, tak apa. Salah kita betulkan ya.
Okay, so teacher teacher show you about the answer. Okay, that means okay, so as teacher Wawa said, ATPase, okay, you can remind the ATPase. Okay, ATPase ni enzyme yang memang ada pada myosin head itu. Okay, so the myosin head hydrolyze ATP to A. Okay, so mention about the ATP first and then go on. Okay, so with ADPs attached myosin head cord. Okay, this is the role of ATP. Okay, so remember what slide, what teachers discuss about the role of ATP in my slide before. Okay, so you see again after this. Okay, and bind to the actin forming actomyosin cross bridge. Okay, myosin cross bridge also can. Acto is what we say, acto ni tak tulis pun tak apa. Yeah, sebab acto that refer to actin. Okay, so myosin cross bridge or cross bridge, forming cross bridge saja pun tak apa. Okay, understood. When ADP and PI are released from the myosin head, it then change to low energy configuration. Okay, low energy configuration is refer to ATP. Okay, still the when we describe the role of ATP. Okay, and then pull the actin towards the center of sarcomere. Okay, and then ATP also bind again to myosin head to detach the apa, the myosin from the actin. That means to what we say, to detach the cross bridge lah. That the role of ATP. Okay, tapi soalan ni dia perlu you all describe. Okay, so biasanya kalau soalan bentuk macam ni, mostly student just take the role. Okay, when the what we say, the keyword sini adalah describe. Okay, describe, explain, okay, about the role of calcium and ATP and then relate to the muscle contraction. Okay, janganlah nanti calcium tu kita terang pada sinaptik yang tadi kan. ATP pun ada juga function kat situ, tapi ni hanya untuk muscle contraction saja. Okay, okay, cikgu rasa finish about the muscle contraction. Okay, using sliding filament hypothesis. Okay, so teacher hope this topic is sometime in essay question. Okay, before this. Okay, so maybe you get going again. Okay, ask you about this one. Okay, so teacher hope for this year, please memorize, okay, whatever the process, okay, or the mechanism of this sliding filament hypothesis. Okay, so teacher Wawa, okay, cikgu finish kat sini je. Okay.
Akhiri kelas kita, saya nak bagi kod yang terakhir, iaitu kod yang keempat kita, iaitu nombor 8. Okay, nombor 8 sekali lagi ya, nombor 8. Baik, so okay, kita dah habis ya kelas kita pada malam ini. Okay, terima kasih banyak-banyak kepada Cikgu Nurnaini binti Harun atas perkongsian ilmu bagi topik sliding filament theory, okay, of muscle contraction. Okay, so saya nak ingatkan semua ya yang mengikuti kelas kita pada malam ini. Okay, kita sebelum kita tamatkan sesi siaran langsung ini, mohon tutup ruangan chat dan klik butang subscribe ya. Aktifkan ikon loceng supaya anda tidak terlepas untuk sesi kelas seterusnya. Dan juga sebelum sila type down di ruang komen sebelum like CJ akan diberikan sebagai tanda terima kasih kepada cikgu kerana kehebatan kamu untuk kelas percuma pada malam ini. Okey, ingat kod yang diberikan, okey, dan juga kumpul kredit anda dengan segera ya. Sebab kod tu available untuk 15 minit sahaja selepas kelas ini. So link CJ boleh didapatkan daripada okey bahagian chat. So sila ambil perhatian, link tersebut akan tamat, okey, untuk CJ lah, ni CJ. Okey. Akan tamat dalam tempoh 30 minit selepas live ini. 15 minit untuk kod untuk redeem kredit tadi. Okey, 30 minit untuk link sijil ya. Okey, pastikan anda gunakan email e-didik sahaja. Okey, sekiranya terdapat kesalahan, okey, kita tidak akan layan lah ya. Kalau kamu PM pun cikgu tak layan ya. So kelas seterusnya, okey, pada untuk tuition biology pra-university, okey, pada minggu hadapan pada pukul 9:30 malam hari yang sama iaitu Sabtu. Okey, anda dijemput ke portal www.academyyoutuber.com untuk dapatkan info terkini. Okey, dan sebelum kita akhiri kelas kita pada malam ini, cikgu-cikgu yang lain di konti boleh nak ada sepatah dua kata. Cikgu, kita mulakan dengan Cikgu Faizah, ketua panitia kita.
Okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and a very good afternoon to all my beloved friends, eh, Cikgu Naini as a presenter, Cikgu Wawa as moderator and our senior Cikgu Fatiah. Okay, thank you for all the students for attending the class tonight. Okay, thank you Cikgu Naini. It's a very interesting topic where teacher Naini already explained step by step, okay, about this muscle contraction. And like you all know, okay, that this topic is actually you need to really understand, okay? Because currently, matriculation students also your final SPSM, eh? Okay, they also this question come out which carry 8 marks, but the question asks about the role of ATPase, okay, the enzyme that on the myosin head. Right. Thank you Cikgu Naini for sharing. So hoping you can see this video again, okay, for you to understand better. Right, thank you. See you next week insyaAllah.
Okay, thank you Cikgu Faizah. Okay, seterusnya kita pergi kepada Cikgu Fatiah.
Okay, assalamualaikum, boleh dengar eh? Cikgu ucapkan terima kasih lah kepada pelajar, semua pelajar dan juga semua audien lah ya yang menonton untuk malam ni. Tadi cikgu nampak ada pelajar yang macam confused sikit lah for the essay question about the function, the role of calcium kan. Calcium and describe kan the role of calcium and ATP in the muscle contraction. So most of the student tu biasanya dia macam just list kan, list the function, list the role. But describe ni meaning here, student must explain macam sequence lah. Yeah? Sequence in the muscle contraction. One more is about the calcium tadi, ada satu pelajar yang macam dia confused kan. Dia start dengan neuromuscular, neurotransmitter. Actually for the calcium ion tu, dia start daripada from the TTPU tu, dia enter the sarcoplasmic reticulum kan, meaning when the extension potential, action, dengar tak, I have a problem in sound kan, hopefully okay, can tak hear, the student must bear in mind when the action potential dia arrive at the post membrane kan, in the muscle tu. Dia start kat situ, bukan daripada presynaptic membrane. Dia post prosynaptic membrane, dia daripada post synaptic membrane tu in the muscle tu. Dia start kat situ calcium ion tu. Yeah? Tadi ada pelajar tu dia macam dia confused. Yeah? So the student must bear in mind. So you have to remember when the action potential reach the postsynaptic membrane, meaning in the muscle fiber tu, and then the action potential will macam activate lah, dia akan pergi kepada sarcolemma. Sarcolemma is the plasma membrane ya, for the muscle fiber, and then go to the T-tibule. From the T-tibule it will go down to the sarcoplasmic reticulum, and then from there dia akan what dia akan link with the what we call the filament. Dia akan link dengan the light filament lah. The apa dia actin tadi kan? In the actin they it has troponin and tropomyosin. So the student must bear the, in mind relation tu. Yeah, jangan hafal je. You have understand. Start dengan structure tu kan. Last week I already explain about the structure of neuromuscular junction. The structure the student must understand baru dia boleh faham. The student can understand about the what we call the the sliding filament hypothesis. Itu sajalah daripada cikgu. Cikgu Hanani Tania dapat present dengan baik dengan gambar rajah dengan semualah Tania congratulations good luck for the student ya. Itu saja dari cikgu. Thank you
Cikgu Fatiah. Okay, so student, kalau kita tengok tadi jawapan kawan kamu tadi yang Cikgu Fatiah huraikan ya, dua perkara berbeza ya bila kita nak elaborate neuromuscular junction. Okay, perkara berlaku dekat neuromuscular junction, okay, bergerakkan neurotransmitter, vesikel, okay, so itu neuromuscular junction punya event ya. Sliding filament theory more to the sarcomere ataupun actin-myosin punya pergerakan lah. Okay, so awak boleh tengok balik video Cikgu Fatiah ya untuk kelas last week, okay, yang pasal neuromuscular junction itu. Okay, so dengan itu ya, terima kasih banyak-banyak. So jangan lupa share okay, kelas kita kepada ramai lagi rakan kamu di luar sana. Okay, teruskan dengan kita untuk topik seterusnya pada minggu hadapan. Okay, pada waktu dan masa yang sama. Okay, stay tune. So sehingga itu sahaja pada malam ini. Bye semua. Assalamualaikum. Selamat malam.
Berikutan pengumuman penutupan sekolah sehingga akhir persekolahan. Pengajaran dan pembelajaran secara home-based learning tetap diteruskan. Oleh itu, kami di Akademi YouTuber menyediakan tuition online percuma pertama di Malaysia dari prasekolah hinggalah ke sekolah menengah dengan kerjasama eDidik Malaysia dan Kelab Guru Malaysia. Kenapa bayar jika anda boleh dapat percuma? Bermula percuma, selamanya akan percuma. Manfaatkan peluang yang ada. Jangan tunggu lagi, sertailah sekarang. Untuk maklumat lanjut, layari www.academyyoutuber.com.
Dibawakan kepada anda oleh Akademi YouTuber.